Hi everyone, my name is Vamshi Borgansi. I'm from the Pennsylvania State University in Exton, PA, and my major is industrial engineering. And I'm here as a continuous improvement intern at Clorox. My house is, you know, that's supposed to be my e-garment profile. I don't actually know how I got there.
Oops.
We'll move over then. Today I'm going to talk about kind of an overview of my internship, my two projects, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about kind of the activities I did outside of Clorox, and then just talk about my overall experience here. So I worked in the as a continuous improvement intern in the WCO division under Jeff Mueller, specifically under performance tracking. And you know, WCO is kind of a unique environment as opposed to other engineering principles, because we don't always have a set project where we establish a problem and then develop a solution to come with a a measurable solution. I was assigned to different clients, and I was able to help the clients understand the reports that they were using, see, make sure that the clients were using the reports how they were supposed to use the reports. I was able to get clients' input on if the reports were matching their needs, and then made strategic recommendations on how to improve the reports going forward. And because of the unique work environment of WCO, our work kind of ebbed and flowed. Some days we would have very easy days, and not easy in the term of work, but easy in the sense that the clients were using reports how they were supposed to be used, the reports were working, there wasn't too many problems. And then some days, usually right after a scorecard period closed after a quarter, we would have a lot of requests come in at once with just manual fixes we had to do. And on those days, I kind of felt like this. But whenever I felt like that, I talked to my manager, and he reminded me that all of our work goes down to a central principle. We simplify, standardize, and sustain reports. Moving forward, I'm going to talk a little bit about my first project with Clorox Applications. Clorox Applications is a data-driven report that helps preventative and autonomous maintenance. What it does is basically it's a database of all of our equipment and unit ops through our 40-some plants, and we're able to tag these equipment and unit ops with designations responding to how much maintenance they need. The designations are A, B, and C. A designations respond to equipment that need continuous maintenance, such as the tires on your car. If your tires on your car broke, you need to replace them when the car wouldn't work. The advantage of this report is when we have 10 or 15 hours of maintenance time, we can prioritize our resources and make sure that we're working on the things that need the most help. Now, the problem with this report was it was based on an archaic technology. This report was created almost 14 years ago. So right now, it's doing something vastly different than it was originally created to do. Additionally, since the report has changed so much, there wasn't super effective training on it. So every time the report was handed on from an individual to another individual, it took them a couple days or a couple weeks to get to the point where they could handle the report perfectly. And furthermore, as we got new equipment and new unit ops and plants, they weren't effectively entered into the database, and we weren't using the report to its full ability. So what do? We created a standardized process to upload all of the unit ops and equipment to the plants, regardless of what the plant size was or what the plant business unit was. We created a very detailed job aid to make sure that the training process was smooth and efficient, no matter who got it and as long as we wanted for the future. And then we identified a strategy to actually get rid of this manual section altogether. So when I came in, it took a new individual 5 days to do a unit op transfer. By the time the standardized equipment process was developed, it took an untrained worker half a day to do this process, and then in the future, obviously, we're going to eliminate this process altogether. So the main things I learned from this project is project improvement is great, but project sustainability is the most important thing. No matter how much of a benefit we get from creating the process, we can get infinitely more benefit from sustaining that gain for years to come. And then I also learned that when we create a job, it is really important to transfer why we're doing something and not just how. Oftentimes, when we create a job aid or some kind of training program, we talk about how to do a process, but it's just as important to understand why that process is even being done. Especially in the case of Clorox Applications, when it's a 14-year-old technology, oftentimes we saw pieces where we were like, why does this even exist? When we dug deeper, we realized that it existed for a key critical point. If we just deleted that, then we would have had to realize that that was important and had to spend time to recreate it. To be agile, to eliminate waste, we need to understand the technology, not just how to use it, how it works within the wider Clorox infrastructure. And I also learned that when you create a process, you really have to make it flexible. With the way technology is changing nowadays, in 2 or 3 years, what we use now is going to be completely obsolete or completely different. So we need to make processes that will evolve with the technologies. My next project was a contract manufacturing scorecard. This was a holistic overview of how our co-pad group are doing. This allowed contract manufacturers to see how their co-packers were doing and respond to a problem before they became an issue. Now the problem with this is there were about 7 different reports pointing off the same data. There were 7 reports doing essentially very similar things. Each of this report was also very complex. The reporting logic was built into the report itself, which means that if we made an overall change, say we came up with a new metric we had to record, we would have to go into every project, every report individually and make that change, which just took too long. So what did we do to solve that? We standardized the report at the data level, and what that means is essentially we created a data structure that all the reports pointed to, and all that means is if we wanted to make an overarching change to all of the reports, we would just have to change that data layer and it would change everything very quickly. Also, we reduced the amount of reports from 6 to 2 to less complexity. The major things I learned from this project is oftentimes we really have to consider if a request is value added or not. Oftentimes, clients don't understand the technical necessities of a project. So when they say they need something, it's usually they want something, and we have to make sure that what they want corresponds with what they need. And I also learned that when we think about how many resources it takes to support a project, we have to think really about how much resources it will take to sustain the project, not just how many resources it will take to create the project in the first place. So Clorox was a really interesting opportunity for me because I was very, and I still am, but I was very young in my professional and personal life when I came here. Before I came here, I never lived by myself, I never drove by myself, I never cooked, I never cleaned, I never did anything. So, I don't even know how I got here today. Before I got to Clorox, I never drove by myself. Today, I drove myself here, so that it's the little wins that really count. So I got to experience a lot of, I guess, pseudo-adult life, and, you know, that helped. I also got to experience a lot of cool experiences. I bought a unicycle, tried the unicycle, fell off the unicycle, returned the unicycle, but it was, the fact that I tried is really what matters. And the new experiences aren't going to end. We're going to a Braves game as an intern class in a week or so, and that's going to be my first baseball game. One really cool thing that I started to do here at Clorox that became kind of a hobby of mine is I went to a lot of open mics to do stand-up comedy. I went to about 10 to 15 over the course of my internship, and that really was a cool way to experience a different type of professional speaking, different than how you would do in a professional environment, but it still helped my skills. And it also was a good way to explore different parts of the Atlanta that I wouldn't necessarily explore by myself. So I just want to end by giving acknowledgments to the people who made this internship so great for me. My team, Jeff Mueller, Sarah Grath, Josh, Carolyn Redeker, and Johnny Kerwinkle were instrumental in making sure that I didn't completely crash and burn. Johnny Weaver, Portland Sterling, and Joy Jackson were individuals I worked with very deeply on my projects. And I just want to end with an asymptote. It is asymptote, right?
Anecdote. Okay. Stand up. Stand up.
You can tell.
That's a good tough part.
Yeah. Basically, Samantha Good and Josh Gross were two individuals who were very instrumental in getting me to work here at Clorox. One was my hiring manager, one was my interviewer. But the interesting thing was before I even got to Clorox, they both transitioned into different roles. One went to Arkansas, one went to a different office in Atlanta. But when I got here, it didn't seem like they left. You know, they kept in touch with me, they made sure that I was fitting in, they made sure that I was having fun, they made sure that all the resources I needed were here. And what that really showed me, beyond anything else, is that everyone here cares. You know, everyone in this room wants everyone else to succeed for no other reason that we care about each other. It doesn't matter if it personally improves your career or not, you just want everyone to succeed. And that, you know, essence of caring is something I'm going to take with me no matter where my career goes. And I think that's going to make all the difference. Thank you. Oh, yeah, questions.
So you did return the unicycle.
I'm in the process of returning the unicycle. Does anyone want to buy a unicycle?
One thing you cited is, actually might not have felt like an opportunity, is not initially having a specific project, but having a client.
Yes.
Could you describe how you kind of started up that relationship and determined where you'd focus?
So the really cool thing about this project was it wasn't a new client per se, it was a client process that we were already in. So I got to do it, and then all the break fixes that we were treating, I got to learn the process a lot better by fixing it over and over and over again, and then that developed a relationship with the client, because every time something broke, they messaged me, I fixed it, and then that built a little bit of trust, so they knew that we could fix it, and then they talked about what they really needed in the project. We kind of talked about what we needed in the project, so we would have to support it less, so it was more stable. And then based on that, we were able to make strategic recommendations that helped both sides. Yeah. Any other questions? Okay, thank you.